Hello children, good morning. Welcome to the online class of English 2. Yes, the previous class, we had started a new lesson and we had completed almost the explanation of the lesson. The lesson was lesson 2, Heidi meets her grandfather. Now today I will read the lesson once again for you, the whole lesson in one go. And we will little bit recap what we had seen and read on that day, understood on that day. Okay, so I will read the lesson in one go for you. Heidi meets her grandfather. This story is about Heidi, a small girl. When her parents die, she goes to stay with her aunt named Date. When Date gets a job in Frankfurt, she leaves Heidi with her grandfather, who lives up a mountain in Switzerland. The old man tells Date that he does not know what to do with a child. But the aunt leaves her there in any case. Grandfather is considered odd and dreadful. Now, read the story to find out how little Heidi makes her bed in the hay loft of her grandfather's hut. As soon as Date had disappeared, the old man went back to his bench, and there he remained seated, staring on the ground without uttering a sound. Heidi, meanwhile, was enjoying herself in her new surroundings. She continued her search and presently came to the fir trees behind the hut. A strong breeze was blowing through them, and there was a rushing and roaring sound in their topmost branches. Heidi stood still and listened. The sound growing fainter, she went on again to the farther corner of the hut and so round to where her grandfather was sitting. Seeing that he was in exactly the same position as when she left him, she went and placed herself in front of the old man, and putting her hands behind her back, stood and gazed at him. Her grandfather looked up, and as she continued standing there without moving, "What is it you want?" he asked. "I want to see what you have inside the house," said Heidi. "Come then." And the grandfather rose and went before her towards the hut. The old man opened the door and Heidi stepped inside after him. She found herself in a good-sized room, which covered the whole ground floor of the hut. A table and a chair were the only furniture. In one corner stood the grandfather's bed. In another was the hearth, with a large kettle hanging above it. And on the further side was a large door in the wall. This was the cupboard. "Where am I to sleep, grandfather?" "Wherever you like," he answered. Heidi was delighted. In the corner near her grandfather's bed, she saw a short ladder against the wall. Up she climbed and found herself in the hay loft. there lay a large heap of fresh, sweet-smelling hay. While through a round window in the wall, she could see right down the valley. "I shall sleep here, Grandfather," she called down to him. "It's lovely up here. Come up and see how lovely it is." "Oh no, I know all about it," he called up in answer. "I am getting the bed ready now," she called down again, as she went busily to and fro at her work. "But I shall want you to bring me up a sheet. You can't have a bed without a sheet. You want it to lie upon." "All right," said the grandfather. And presently he went to the cupboard, and after rummaging about inside for a few minutes, he drew out a long coarse piece of stuff, which was all he had to do duty for a sheet. He carried it up to the loft, where he found Heidi had already made quite a nice bed. She had put an extra heap of hay at one end for a pillow, and had so arranged it that when in bed, she would be able to see comfortably out through the round window. So children, this is the whole lesson, the whole story. I already told you, this story is an extract from the book Heidi, which was written by Joanna Lewis Spivey. Okay, now in this lesson, there is one girl, small girl, maybe of 5 years or 6 years, 5 to 6 years of age. She is an orphan girl. Orphan means the children who don't have their parents, own parents, mother or father, means mother and father both have died, and that child is called an orphan. So she was an orphan, and she had to stay with her aunt. Aunt means mother's sister. She had to stay with her aunt, and her name was Date. But this young lady, she got a job in Frankfurt, so she was unable to take Heidi along her. So what she thought? She thought that she would leave Heidi with her grandfather. So they both came up to grandfather. Grandfather was living near the mountains, near the forest. And so they went and met the grandfather. Now, grandfather was not an ordinary man. He was a bit difficult to handle. He was not mingling and adjusting with other people. So he was staying all alone outside the village near the forest. Okay, his hut was outside the village. Now, the grandfather is refusing. He is saying no to Date, that he cannot handle this small little girl. And he said that he will not keep this child. But Aunt Date was confirmed. She was firmed in her decision to leave Heidi with her grandfather. So Aunt Date leaves her there with her grandfather, and she leaves for her town. Now the story begins. The grandfather is now sitting on a bench thinking what to do, and the girl, the small girl, is very busy and excited to see the new place. She is going through the place. She is going all through the place. She is making an visit to the places surrounding the hut. And what all she comes across? There are very tall trees, that is fir trees, and because the hut was near the mountain, so the area is covered, the area was covered with fir trees. So the girl is moving around the forest nearby and she comes across the places. She makes one round and comes back and stands in front of grandfather, and she is astonished and surprised to see the grandfather again in the same position as she had left him few minutes before. So what she is doing now, she is trying to talk to the old man. Heidi is trying to talk to that old man, means her grandfather. She is trying to talk to her and she is saying that, what I want to see inside, what is there inside your hut. So the grandfather agrees and he takes her inside the hut. And as soon as she reaches inside the hut, she sees the place and the things, what all things the grandfather is having, what all furnitures the grandfather is having. For the name of furniture, he was only having a chair and a table on one side. On the other side was kept a bed on which he used to lie upon. The other side of the wall was having one door. It was not actually a door, it was a cupboard. Then one wall had a ladder which led to the upstairs room, and it was a hay loft. Actually the hay was kept there. So she is inspecting the whole house, okay, and she is trying to talk to the grandfather meanwhile. She is also worried where she will be sleeping, and the same question which arises in her mind, she is asking her grandfather that, grandfather, where will I sleep? So her grandfather is saying that you can sleep anywhere, wherever she likes. After listening this, she was very happy. So she sees the whole room, she cannot find a place. Then she climbs the ladder and reaches the hay loft, the place where all the hay was kept. Fresh, sweet smelling hay was kept. I told you that day what is hay. Hay is the dry part which is left behind when the crop is harvested. After cutting, the grains are kept inside, are stored, and what is left is the hay, the straw, the dry straw, the dry plant which is left is known as hay. Now this place, this room is made to store the hay for future. The hay is kept there to use for the future. So the girl is very excited to reach there. After reaching there, she is so happy. She says that grandfather, and she is calling her grandfather who is working down, who is still there down and doing some work. She calls him and says that, grandfather, please come and see how lovely this place is. And then grandfather responds is that, I know it very well, what kind of place it is and how the thing is. So Heidi decides that she will sleep here, means in the hay loft. She makes a bed for herself out of hay. I told you that day that olden times people used to make the bed out of hay. Poor people especially, they used to make, when they had nothing to sleep on, they used to make the bed out of hay, and why the hay was used. So she makes a bed out of hay. She piles up the hay in such a manner that it takes the shape of a bed. She takes some extra hay and puts it towards one side, heaping it up, piling it up, and giving it a shape of a pillow. So now she is worried that she needs a sheet on it. She cannot lie on the hay directly. So she calls for her grandfather once again. and she says that grandfather, I need a sheet, something to spread it on this, and then only I can lie upon this. So grandfather, he just moves towards the cupboard and takes out one coarse piece of cloth. Coarse means rough, hard, okay, coarse piece of cloth, and he brings that cloth up in the hayloft and gives it to Heidi, and she is very happy. They both make the bed, and Heidi has made the bed in such a manner that when she will lie down on the bed, on that bed which she has made, the window, the round window which was there in that place, that room, she will directly see through the window without getting up. Like by lying down only, she will be able to see through the window, and she is very happy. So this is the lesson. Now today what we will do is, I hope children you have understood. If you have not understood, the only solution to this is you have to read it thrice, or maybe any number of time you like, but you have to read the lesson on your own. Try to read the lesson on your own. I hope you people have got the books till now. If you have not got it till now, you will soon get it. You can read the story. You have to read the story on your own. Okay? You have to read it. And then only you will come to know what is in the story. What is all about in the story. Okay? Then, today we will be doing the exercises which are given in the book. Some fill in the blanks and some exercises related to the chapters are there in the book. We will do that. And the question and answer, word meaning, and some exercises which are to be done in the notebook, it will be provided on the school's website, from where you have already copied the previous lesson ones, question and answer and word meaning. The address of the website is lfsraptinagar.ac.in, lfsraptinagar.ac.in. You can get this address in your old diaries also. The address is already, the school's website is already written there. So you can get the study material, the writing part which is to be written in your notebook from there. I'll provide the things. Now, the previous lesson was a poem. The poem was not having any difficult words. This is a proper lesson. We will have difficult words in this. Around 15 difficult words I will give you. You have to write it. I'll show you how to do the work, this lesson's work, in the copy. I'll show to you. Before that, let's do the exercises which are given in the book. So children, come, let us do the book exercises which are given there on page number 14. The first exercise is fill in the blanks. So I will provide you the answers there on the website also, and we will be doing it right now also. You can copy the answers from there. Okay. Now, number one says, when Heidi's parents died, she went to live with her dash called Date. So the answer will be aunt. A-U-N-T. Aunt. I hope you can see this. I'm writing with the pencil. And yes, whatever things you will write in your book, you will use your pencil. Nothing else. No writing with pen, nothing. Only pencil you have to use, okay? Now, number two.
Heidi stood still and listened to the sounds made by strong dash. Made by strong dash. That is, answer is breeze. B-R-E-E-Z-E. Breeze. Okay. Now, number three. A table and a chair were the only dash in grandfather's room. And the answer is furniture. F-U-R-N-I-T-U-R-E. Furniture. Number four. The short ladder near the bed took her to the dash. The short ladder I told you that day, ladder means staircase. The short ladder near the bed took her to the loft. L-O-F-T. Hay loft. Okay. H-A-Y-L-O-F-T. Hay loft. Then, she had put an extra heap of hay at one end of the dash. She had put an extra heap of hay at one end for a, what she made at one end? Pillow. P-I-L-L-O-W. P-I-L-L-O-W. So, with this we finish the fill in the blanks. Now, come to page number 16. Here, these exercises are based on your grammar. Okay? Grammar. Look at the pictures. Read the group of words. A clump of trees. A class of students. A herd of goats. A range of mountains. A troop of dancers. A chest of drawers. Now, here these highlighted red color words are called collective nouns. They are called collective nouns because they are the name given for the collection of trees. The name clump is the given name for the collection of trees. Okay, class is the name, is the word given to the collection of students. Fine. Then goats, a herd of goats. Herd is the word name given to collection of goats. Then mountain, range is the name word given to the collection of mountains, and so on. Troop of dancers, chest of drawers. Okay, so these words are collective nouns that tells us about a collection of people, animals or things are called collective nouns. You must have studied in your, you will be studying in your grammar. Okay, till now you have not reached that lesson. But you, when you will study nouns, you will study this also. Collective noun is it. Collective noun is one of the kind of nouns. In class 2, you have already studied common noun and proper noun. And now, in common noun and proper noun. So, and collective noun is also one of the kind of nouns, types of noun. So, collective is the noun that tells us about the collection of people. Collection means group, more than 2, more than 3, more than 4, more than 5. Okay, collection means group of people. Group of what? Group of people, animals and things. Group of people, animals and things is called collective noun. Okay, now the exercise is you have to fill the following blank, complete the blanks with collective nouns. The answer is given here in the box. You have to pick the correct answer and write it down here. And please note it down. The number goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this way. Not in the horizontal way, but in the vertical way, okay? So, number 1 says, a dash of kettle. A dash of kettle. Kettle is cows, buffaloes, together they make a kettle. So, what is... will we fill here? What we will fill here? We will fill here herd. H-E-R-D. Herd of cattle. Number 2. A dash of ships. A dash of ships. It is S-H-I-P-S. Ships. Okay? S-H-I-P-S. Ships. S-H-I-P-S. Ships. And there is one word, S-H-E-E-P, that is called sheep. Yes, the difference is pronunciation different. There is a difference, okay? There is a difference. S-H-I-P, ship, and S-H-E-E-P, sheep. S-H-I-P, sheep, S-H-I-P, ship is jahaz, jise hum kehte hain. And S-H-E-E-P, sheep is an animal. Okay, so here what we are going to fill? A dash of ships. So here we will fill fleet. Fleet of ships. Okay, now number 3. A dash of ants. Collection of ants. Where there is a lot of ants are there. What is it called? It is called colony of ants. It's called a colony of ants. Then number 4, a dash of pigeons. Pigeons, birds. It's okay. So, it will be a flight. F-L-I-G-H-T. Flight of pigeons. Then number 5 says a dash of bees. Number 5 says a dash of bees. So, it is a swarm of bees. Okay. Then, 6th number says a dash of books. Books, a collection of books is known as library. So, library of books. Then, number 7 is a dash of flowers. Bunch of flowers. A dash of actors. A dash of actors. Cast of actors. Cast. That is why when we go for a movie and the names are shown, there we can see casting crew, na? Casting. So, a cast of actors. A dash of athletes. Team. All the athletes put together, they become a team. A dash of robbers. Gang of robbers. Okay? Gang of robbers. Gang of robbers. Now, next page we have an exercise. One more. We have to underline something. Yes? Read this. Hay, trees, cotton, gold. These words are names of materials or substances out of which things are made. Things are made. Such words are called material nouns. Okay? Now, underline material noun in these sentences. Page number 17. The dress is made of cotton. The dress is made of cotton. What we will underline? We will underline here cotton. Okay. Iron is very useful material. Iron is very useful material. Yes, iron. Underline iron. The Taj Mahal is made of marble. The Taj Mahal is made of marble. Yes, marble is a material, a kind of stone. Okay? Taj Mahal is made out of marble, white marble, it is said. Then, the crown is made of gold. The crown is made of gold. Gold, okay? I drink coffee in the morning. I drink coffee in the morning. So, coffee. You should drink 2 glasses of milk every day. Number 6, you should drink 2 glasses of milk every day. Your milk. It's a thing, material. So all these words which we have underlined, cotton, iron, marble, gold, coffee, milk, these are all materials. Okay? These are all material. Now, next exercise, punctuation. You can see here, punctuation. Okay? This way. You have to put full stop, question mark, or an exclamatory mark at the end of the sentence. The place is given, the place is provided. You have to read the sentence, find out which type of sentence it is, and you have to put proper punctuation mark. Okay, now let's start. Number one, open the door. Open the door. It's a statement. It's an order actually. Open the door. So we will put a full stop. Why is the sky blue? Why is the sky blue? Question mark. What we will put? We will put a question mark because we are asking a question. This house is huge. This house is huge. Huge means very big. This house is huge. Again, full stop. It's a statement. Okay? We are telling about a quality of a house. It's a statement. Do you want ice cream? Do you want ice cream? What will be your answer? Yes, I will eat an ice cream. So, this is a question. So, we will put a question mark over here. Okay? Question mark. Then, what a beautiful day it is. I hope you are able to see it. I have to still learn. What a beautiful day it is. Yes, we are in a surprise this thing. What a beautiful day it is. We will put exclamatory mark. Then, Lena rode her bicycle to school yesterday. Again, we are saying a statement, full stop. So, with this, children, we finish our exercises in the book. This much only you have to do in your book. And please do it with pencil. Do it with pencil. Now, I will show you. Now, I will show you how to do your work in your English 2 notebook, fair notebook. This is your lesson. Same way, again, you will start with the date. You will write here the date, whichever date you are writing. If you are writing it today, you will write it 8/5/2020. If you are writing it tomorrow, you can write it 9/5/2020, and so on. Please put the date, okay? After putting the date, again, on the first line below the margin, you will write lesson number. Then leave one line. Next line, you will write the name of the lesson. Heidi meets her grandfather. Then leave line. You can draw a line to make a partition like this. And then you will write difficult words. Difficult words like this. Heading. Okay. Touch the margin. Children, please, whatever you write, except the heading, which is written, which is to be written on in the center of the page, okay? Except for the heading, all the other things, there is a broad margin, red color margin given in the copy. Every first words, first letter of the first of whichever line, first word of whichever line, every line in fact, should touch the margin, okay? Should touch the margin. So here you will write difficult words. The 15 difficult words you will get there in the website, okay? School's website. You can copy it down from there and note it down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. On the same page, draw a line with a scale and pencil. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, this side on the same page. Then you can turn a page, you can turn the page, then word meaning. Heading you will put as word meaning. Okay, you will put the heading as word meaning. No need to write lesson number and the name of the lesson. It is understood. We are writing the word meanings of lesson number 2. Then put the number 1 to 5. Draw a line in between. Words on one side, meanings on the other side. Draw a line with pencil and scale. Use the scale. After writing this, again, drawing a line with a pencil, write question answers. Copy the question answers from the book. Question, you can copy it down from the book. But the question answers will be there in the website also. The whole thing will be there. So question number 1 and so on. You have to leave 2 lines after each set of question and answer and draw a line after each set of question and answer as I told you that day. Then what new thing we are going to do here is reference to context. Reference to the context. What is reference to the context? I'll explain to you. Actually, a statement, a quotation, somebody said something in the lesson. The words are taken, the line is taken from in between the lesson, and with that line is given, and with that line, around 3 to 4 questions are asked on the basis of that particular line. Okay, and you have to answer it. You have to answer it. That is called a reference to the context. Okay, that is called reference to the context. How to write it? How to write it in your this thing, notebook? Heading you will put a reference to the context, and be sure whichever page you are finishing with the question answer, leave that page. If you are finishing it here in the half of the page is left, don't continue it on the same page. Reference to the context is to be done on the new page. Okay, please make it a point, because it will be easy for you to learn. While you will learn the question and answer, you will not get confused. So we have to write it separately. Question answers, after finishing question answer, reference to the context on the new page, not on the same page. Please make it sure. Please make it sure that you will write it on the new page. So here you will put the heading reference to the context like this. Then number 1. So inverted with inverted commas. What is it you want? Okay. This is question number 1 which is there in the book. What is it you want? Inverted commas, close. Then leave 2 lines and write A. Question A is given here in the book. You have to write it down in your notebook also. So, who said these words and to whom? Okay, who said these words and to whom? Grandfather said these words to Heidi, and so on. So, you will have question number B, question number C. Then again leave 3 lines and then you can start with the number 2. So you have to write it down. Okay children, so thank you so much. Meet you now on Monday, and the things will be provided on the website. It is an request. It's a request to you and to your parents, especially to your parents. Please guide your children to do the work properly, nicely, because these things will not be repeated till today. It's like it will not be repeated when the school reopens. Yes, we will clarify the doubts, but proper detailed study will not be done. So, and the work which are provided, which we are giving, it is better you do it today and maybe till tomorrow, but try to complete it in this time span. Don't pile it on that, okay, today I'll not do, tomorrow I'll do tomorrow, and that tomorrow will never come. And children, that tomorrow will never come. So do your work then and there, that same day. Try to finish your work on the same day so that you too will have some time and some extra time for yourself. Okay, so thank you so much. God bless you all.